Hello and welcome to the Feminine as Fuck podcast. I'm your host, Monica Yates, a period and women's life coach, where I help women to harness the power of their period and connect back to their true superpowers. In these episodes, we'll be talking about all things periods, vaginas, hormones, women's health, sex, confidence, food, femininity, and all the stuff that goes through our heads. You'll walk away from each episode with new nuggets and truth bombs, as I don't seem to have a filter and I love talking about all the shit that people are too afraid to say, but everyone is thinking. Hello, friends. I hope you're all having a fucking epic day. Okay, so new episode, obviously, and I was thinking about this last night because I had just gotten, like, I'm doing two episodes in one day, like I'm recording two in one day because, like, life gets busy and then I need to have, like, backup plans. So I was actually just talking about this with a friend the other day, and I'm really lucky. One of my best friends, she is, like, fucking amazing and, you know, not a jealous bone in her body. She's the sort of friend that I can, like, you know, text my wins to, like, oh my God, this happened. Oh my God, like, I made this much money this week. I just signed this many clients this week. I just did this. And there's no, like, oh, look at Monica. Oh, like, Monica's being cocky. Like, none of that. It's like, because I don't do it from a cocky place. I do it like a I'm so proud of myself place. Anyway, and I'm really lucky that I have her because she totally sees that, totally sees me for me, and like doesn't think any of that. And I was just thinking about like how women these days fucking tear each other down, like absolutely no one's business. And it's really fucks me off because I'm like, when we heal, everybody heals. When we hurt, everybody hurts. Like we are a collective and we need to fucking work together. Anyway, and as I was kind of like about celebrating my own success last night with like getting, you know, on the top charts of the podcast overnight and having like hundreds and hundreds of listens literally in 24 hours, I was like, holy shit, this is incredible. And my mastermind is sold out, the first one I'd done, and I was like, ah, like I was so excited. But what's really important for me to mention is that like I have not that many friends that I can do that to because majority of women, and for the ones that I can, you know who you are and I love you so much, but the majority of women and for majority of us, women are like so bitchy towards each other. We have this thing called comparisonitis where women just tear each other down these days, and it's because on some level we're comparing ourselves and feeling inadequate, so we want to bring down others on our level to make our ego feel better, and it's fucked up. Like it happened to me end of last year. Like I get hate mail all the time and like that's fine. That's part of being online. Like it really does not fucking bother me because like I know my truth. I know what I'm doing is correct. And like it's their own insecurities, like whatever. Like I just, it's not going to stop me from doing what I'm doing because I help so many women and I know that and I know my value. Anyway, we're not going to go on that train. But what I was going to say was I get a lot of hate mail, but I've never gotten hate mail that's like been really, really personal until some old school girls, and I'm obviously not going to mention names or anything, but if they're listening, they're going to know who they are. And they probably wanted a reaction from me, but like I actually don't give two shits. They wrote some really effing nasty comments on one of my posts, but it was so obvious that one of them had written it and they'd put it in like a group chat and then they could all go and like it because like 13 of them had liked this comment and then they all just had like a big go at me or whatever. Like I was actually just like, this is the lamest thing ever. Like they have that much time in their lives to go and do this. Like that's how unfulfilled they are obviously because they feel the need to do this to me. And of course, a part of them is jealous. Like I said before, right? It's comparisonitis. Women are tearing each other down these days and it's because on some level, they are comparing themselves to me and they're feeling inadequate because they're not in alignment with their truth. So they want to bring me down to their level to make their ego feel better. How fucked up is that? But how fucking true is that? And I'm sure that you can relate to this in some area of your life or even like old, like back in school days, if you were ever bullied or picked on or whatever for being a little bit different. And for a lot of us and a lot of my clients actually, like they know their truth. They know what they want to do, but they hold themselves back because they are afraid of judgment, because they are afraid of what their family going to say, what are the women going to say, or they already know their other friends make silly comments about like whatever their job is or, you know, that sort of stuff, or just having your own business and they just don't get it. Right? They don't get it because a lot of women are too afraid to actually step up and live in alignment because it's a scary place to be because what if it doesn't work? And it is safer to stay in a job that maybe you don't like, but you know it pays really, really well and there's security there. Okay. And I'm not saying that then like everybody has to work for themselves and be a coach or anything like that. Like everybody's got different interests. I've got friends that absolutely
love being lawyers, love business things, love economics, love, you know, being an accountant or whatever. And that's fantastic for them. This is just about doing what's in alignment for you and what sets your soul on fire, okay? So it's really important to actually understand that your relationships with people, whether it's a romantic relationship, a friendship, or, you know, your mum, it mirrors you, okay? It's either a doorway for us to rise or it is the opportunity for our jealousy button to be pressed. Let me reiterate that. Our relationships with people are mirrors for us. It is either a doorway for us to rise or it is the opportunity for our jealousy button to be pressed. Now, the question is, are you seeing these opportunities as a way for you to step the fuck up? Or is your jealousy button being pressed and are you and me one of the bitches that is tearing each other down? Okay, because when you are not in alignment and when you are not happy with who you are, you will hate seeing people rise to their full potential because it is the most threatening thing as you stay put. You feel as though you are inadequate compared to them. And instead of staying in your own bloody lane, you don't. You compare yourself to them because you believe that you aren't enough with where you're at. Okay. If you are constantly comparing yourself to other people or being jealous, it begs the question, are you doing with what's in alignment for yourself? What sets your soul on fire? Okay. And it's not about just getting to, like, quote unquote, your highest truth, or your highest self, like it's some part away from you. Your highest truth, yourself, your soul purpose, your alignment is already within you. You were born with it. So it's about coming back. You don't need to look externally for it. You don't need to look anywhere. You don't need to fucking rise above. You need to look within for the answers, okay? I hope that makes sense. So this mirror, okay, this mirror is showing you everything that you've disowned within yourself. Because if you were really willing to live a fulfilled life, other people's successes wouldn't make you jealous. You'd celebrate them because you aren't wanting what they have because you are happy with what you have. You don't need what they want. You aren't jealous of what they have. Sorry. You aren't jealous. You don't need what they have because you have all the stuff that you want. And great, they might have, you know, a bigger house or whatever, but to you, that's not important. And that's one of the things with, like, you know, to some people, luxury items is really important. And for other people, it's not. And those people that don't love luxury items, they don't then stand jealous of the person that's got the Louis Vuitton handbag or whatever, because it's not in alignment for them. So it's about knowing what it is for alignment with them. And in that particular example, the person without a Louis Vuitton bag isn't jealous of the person with the Louis Vuitton bag because that isn't what serves them. The Louis Vuitton bag wouldn't serve that person, her, but other things would serve her. But because she is in alignment, she's not jealous about it. Okay, does that make sense? So let's say you're a nurse and you fucking love it. Hats off to all the nurses, by the way, and doctors. So let's say you're a nurse and you fucking love it, okay? Then your friend is traveling the world coaching. But because you love your job, you aren't hating on her for doing that. You are so in alignment, okay, in your career that you're happy for her and you don't hate yourself for not being quote unquote as good as her because you are amazing in your own way. You are as good as her in your own way. But if you were hating your job and not in alignment, you'd be jealous as fuck because you'd want that because you are so disconnected from your truth and so afraid to leap into the unknown and step into your power. And you are so fucking jealous that she has taken life by the balls and jumped off the cliff to do what she wants. Okay. So you're also letting fear run your life because it is easier to sit back and procrastinate than to actually act because acting means there is a chance of failure. And you believe that if you fail, you are worthless and not enough. So you'd rather stay small and in your comfort zone because at least you don't risk humiliation. Guess what, babe? You are only ever humiliated if you actually take on that humiliation, if you actually believe what they are saying. Much like, you know, you will only be insulted if on some level what that person has said to you, if on some level you believe it, okay? If on some if somebody says that's not a real job, that will only affect you if on some level you believe that your job is not a real job or if that's an insecurity for you, okay? So you are only ever humiliated if you actually take on the humiliation, much like failure, okay? You only, quote unquote, fail in a bad way if that's how you believe if that's how you interpret failure. If you interpret failure as it's a win-win, you either win or you learn, okay, then you haven't failed. You've learnt. So it depends on your definition. Change the definition of failure and it will seriously change your perception and it will make it so much easier for you to jump off that cliff and do what the fuck you want to do, okay? Because you have a choice. You can change your language and you can always choose. You always have a choice. But if you choose to keep yourself small and not do what you want, then bringing other women or men down for their amazing jobs and taking the leap is just being a fucking bully. And it's happened to me, okay? Like I said in the beginning with my little story, these women that do this, okay, and that do this often won't be aware of this, but the bitchy words isn't from a place of love, right? The bitchy words of them tearing other women down is not from a place of love. It's because they are jealous, and they are jealous that they aren't out crushing their own lives. They are jealous that that woman is out there living her dream, being on purpose, loving life, and they want that. And they are so afraid to go fucking get that, because you can get whatever you want. You can get absolutely whatever you want if you make the choice and if you actually take the leap. Okay, because if these bitches that are saying the bad things or tearing each other down, okay, if they were out living their lives, they wouldn't care what these other women are doing that are living their lives. They wouldn't care. They wouldn't, you know, be affected in a negative way about other women's successes. They would celebrate them. Okay, they'd be cheering them on because their reticular activating system wouldn't be looking for ways to bring them down. So your reticular activating system is basically in your brain. You know, we filter out a lot of things that we see every day, but your brain will focus on what you I'm telling you to focus on. Let's say the classic example is you buy a new car, okay, and then all of a sudden you see that car everywhere, like everywhere, and you're like, what the fuck? I've never seen this car before. How do I now see this car everywhere? That's your reticular activating system. That is why, for example, if you have a negative mindset, you will then continue to see everything in a negative light because your brain hunts out reasons to prove that to you. So these women, okay, these women that don't love their lives, blah, 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 that are tearing other women down, they look for reasons as to why they don't love their lives. They look for reasons, their brain looks for reasons as to why to tear the women's other women's lives down. But if they were in their own alignment and if they were in truth and if they were living a confident lie that was fulfilling and crushing their dreams, their reticular activating system would be looking for other reasons as to why to give praise to other women that are also crushing their dreams, because their reticular activating system would be on, you know, red alert for like, let's see how I can keep crushing goals, keep crushing dreams. It wouldn't be looking for reasons as to why to bring other women down because they're not being jealous fuckers, okay? So your triggers show you where the truth is for you. So if you are being triggered by other women's success or other people's success, whether it's brothers or sisters' success, whether it's parents' success, whether it's friends' success, whether it's boyfriend's success, whoever's success you're being triggered by, okay, it is because they're on some level, this is a doorway for you. Maybe for you, it's that you are jealous that you don't have the guts to do what you want. Okay. Maybe for you, it's that you're not taking enough action. Okay. This is a doorway for you, and it's up to you because you always have a choice. It's up to you whether you want to put your hand on that door and start to slowly open the door and see what's inside. Okay. And of course you don't have to because that's your choice, but then don't go wasting your time being bitchy towards others because you're too afraid to take action. You can stay where you are. You can be comfortable. Hell, it's easier to stay where you are and be comfortable. Fuck yeah, it's easier. It requires less work, less determination, okay, less mind fucks. But is that what you want? Do you want to stay where you are currently right now? Or do you want to grow? Do you want to keep evolving? Of course, there's always going to be the chance that what if it doesn't work out? But babe, let's play the opposite. Let's play that what if it does work out game. What if you actually took the leap and it worked out and you had the life of your dreams? Because guess what? Most of the time, it does end up being that. If you have the right attitude and if you take inspired action, if you trust in the universe, if you have gratitude, if you do all of those right things where you're on a high level and you're bringing in abundance, there is no reason as to why you can't get that. Literally no reason. Okay? So stop being jealous. See how your triggers are actually a doorway for you and start working on them. I hope this podcast, although it was not a long one, I hope, and it's also not long because I have to go to a client in 8 minutes. I hope that you've gotten something out of it though. It was a bit of a rant, but I think it was a good rant because it really just like came to me last night and I was like, I really want to talk about this because it's really important. And I really struggled with this, with being able to actually like feel proud because other people tear me down, or I know that other people are being jealous or they're being cocky or they're fucking leaving bitchy comments on my Facebook page. Like, who the fuck does that? Just shows their true colors. Hey, so, and this isn't about like having a go at them. This is about like, that was an opportunity for them to see, okay, what's actually triggering about me? Am I right? Okay. And what I'm saying in that caption, although they were being a bitchy about it, was I actually right? Okay. And that's why I don't let hate mail get to me, because the only reason someone's replied is because on some level you've triggered them, and eventually that's going to be a doorway for them. So you've actually helped them. So never actually take hate mail to heart. I always see hate mail as a compliment, because you've triggered them, and that's where the trigger that and triggering is good, because that's being a fucking good coach. If I sat back and just patted people on the back, I wouldn't be a good coach. Okay. That is all from me today. I hope you guys got a lot out of today's little nuggets and wrote some notes. You probably want to go back and re-listen to it, because I was talking really fast and absolutely rambling, but I would love for you to rate me, to leave me a little review if you haven't, because I'd really, really appreciate it so we can keep staying in the top charts. And if you haven't already checked out my mastermind, make sure you do so, because we are going to be doing a ton more of this amazing work. The stuff that I talk about in these episodes where I'm like having a massive rant and giving you guys all the downloads, this is the sort of stuff that we do in the mastermind, really focusing on up-leveling, stepping into your power, getting rid of your triggers, helping you get rid of your limiting beliefs and embody, doing a lot of embodiment practices, getting rid of the blockages. So for any woman that wants to, you know, she's feeling a bit stuck, she wants to get more confident, wants to just step out of her like comfort zone and really take that leap, this is for you. The link with all the info is going to be in the show notes. Make sure you have a read, because enrollment for the next round is going to be opening probably by the time this podcast is out. So, because my first one sold out so quickly, so we're going to be going next level for the next one. I'm super excited. So make sure that you check that all out, and I will see you on the flip side. Have an amazing day. Well, thank you again for tuning in and listening to my podcast. I hope that you got lots of nuggets out of today's show. Please, 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 I would be really grateful if you could leave me a review so that more women can find the podcast, and therefore I can help more women understand their period and fix their period problems. Because after all, it's a much nicer life to live when we actually love our cycle, because we do have to keep up with it every single month. Also, if you have any friends or loved ones that you think would enjoy my podcast, I'd be super grateful if you could send it to them as well, just to share the love. And that's it for now. So I will catch you on the flip side. Have an amazing day or night, wherever you are.